Thank you. With that note, I would like to take this honor and privilege to acknowledge Honorable Charles Abel, our member for Alotau. He's not an ordinary member. He is a very strong national leader. He has substantially contributed at the national level, and I think for him to work or accompany our minister is a very positive indication. You know, everywhere we go, we seem to find that you know, members in the opposition don't necessarily work together with the members in the government. But here we are seeing a different different case. So we would like to thank the two leaders for this unity and working together. I would like to also thank take this time to thank the Minister for Agriculture and Livestock, who is a passionate agriculture man. In Maprik they say Action Man John Simon, and he is living to that name, and he is going everywhere in the country, and for specifically he has a blood for cocoa. When you cut his skin, the blood will come down as a chocolate color. So he has a cocoa DNA. President for Suau, without whom we would not be here. His persistence and, you know, knocking on our door all this time has enabled us to really implement what we have signed in December 2018, an MOA between Alotau and Cocoa Board. In this MOA, it's a partnership program where it's a kina for kina, where the DDA contributes one kina and the Cocoa Board puts up one kina. That is how we should be working in partnership, because for Cocoa Board, we cannot do it ourselves. So as much as possible, the DDA is responsible for its farmers, and Cocoa Board, under its mandate, is responsible for delivering cocoa services to the farmers. So we must work together to, you know, deliver that service to our common client, who are our people in the villages. I would like to also take this time to thank the provincial administration, who is represented here by the PA himself. I can see a different mode here now, because the last time we came, we didn't have much cooperation from the former administration, but we are having it now. So thank you very much, PA, and your administration. Church community leaders and youth, thank you very much. Media personnel, not forgetting my good brother and colleague, Managing Director for KIC, thank you. Cocoa and coconut, like the President just mentioned, they would like to go into intercropping. Cocoa and coconut, they go together. So it's not wrong. And most importantly, thank you very much, cocoa growers, cocoa farmers in Laimodo. Under the MOA, since 2019, Cocoa Board and Suau LLG has rolled out 24 nurseries in the various 22 wards of the LLG, and out of that initial planting, more than 50,000 cocos have been planted in the field. In this village alone, as has been alluded to or stated, 7,000 cocoa trees have been planted. Cocoa Board is happy with the support of the government and the minister here. We would like to pledge that You know, why do we plant cocoa? We plant cocoa for some reasons. We plan to get money. The money is the you know, most important common denominator that we are doing cocoa for, or coconut for, or any other ventures. So on that note, I would like to announce here that Cocoa Board will initially put some money up for price support, under the price support that the government has given, to start buying cocoa in this village. In fact, Laimodo and Sagao, they are the initial villages where cocoa has been planted. So I think in order to get the interest going and you know, money flowing, we must put money into where we put money into where it matters most, and that is to give money to the growers so that they can then be able to see the color of the money from the cocoa trees or cocoa why we are farming cocoa. The other project that is undertaken under the cocoa industry plan is the cocoa freight subsidy. In fact, Cocoa Board has in 2016 initially partnered with Milne Bay Provincial Administration and moved 106 metric tons of 106 bags of cocoa. 106 bags of cocoa, and that is about 3 to 4 tons to the market, and that is valued at over 60,000 kina, and about 48,000 going direct to the farmers. And we are thankful to the government. Government has continued to give us freight money, freight subsidy money this year, and therefore we will continue to work with service providers like buyers and processors, where we would like to park the money. For instance, this morning we have met with the Milne Bay SME team, where we have committed some funds so that they can initially start buying cocoa and creating market here in Milne Bay.